thanks for joining us for News 19 at 10. I'm Tamika Alexander.
We're glad you're with us. I'm Ben Hoover. With our children out of school for the summer, parents tend to plan outdoor activities for the whole family.
But as temperatures rise, a popular spot can become dangerous.
Our Kayla Smith joins us live here in the studio tonight with more on how playgrounds pose a threat in the summer. You took the thermometer out and got some surprising results.
I did. I saw some pretty extreme heat out there. I also spoke to families at the park today, and some of them told me they prefer going early in the morning or as the sun starts going down in the evening. Not only is the heat more tolerable during these times, it's also safer. During the hottest parts of the day, playground equipment heats up, reaching temperatures high enough to burn a child's skin.
As the sun beats down, playground temperatures rise. I found that equipment at playgrounds across Madison County regularly reaches temperatures above 100 degrees.
Anything that's too hot for you is too hot for kids.
Dr. Wes Doublefield with the Alabama Department of Public Health says you should check the temperature of the playground equipment before children use it. If it burns the palm of your hand, it's too hot for a child's bare skin.
In the middle of the day when it's very, very sunny, now even if the outside temperature is not that high, surfaces can still get very hot.
Shade makes a difference. The temperature of this slide in the sun clocked in at about 135 degrees. The slide in the shade was nearly 40 degrees cooler. According to the CDC, parents should stick to playgrounds with sunshades if they plan to visit between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. That's when the sun's UV rays are the strongest. And every member of the family needs to make sure they take frequent breaks. Dr. Stubblefield says it's important to listen to your body.
You know, if you start feeling weak or tired, it's time to go inside, cool your body down, get some fluids.
Nausea, headaches, and excessive sweating can all be signs of heat exhaustion. Stubblefield recommends you hydrate before going out, while in the middle of a physical activity, and after you go back inside. And don't forget to reapply sunscreen at least every 2 hours.
And speaking of dangerous heat conditions, HMSE is reporting 9 heat-related incidents from over the weekend. The calls have been from people who have been working or spending time outside. No deaths have been reported. The calls happened between 6 p.m. Friday and 6 a.m. Monday in Madison County.
Good time to bring in